Greetings, everyone, with Ray Ferraro downstairs and Eddie Olchek upstairs. I'm Mike Embry. Tonight, we bring you a matchup between two great teams. Eddie, your sense on all this?
Two teams that have two well-crafted game plans, but once the puck drops, anything can happen, Doc, as we've seen in the past. I believe the key to this game is who stays to their game plan will win this game.
Another terrific night of hockey here. The Canucks get the first play. Oh, look at this! Shoots! Outstanding save. What magic even to get there and get the shot off.
Not often you're all alone in front of the goaltender from this area of the ice. Great save.
Kelowna setting it up as they move through center. Big drive! Score! What a great early start for the home squad. The Rockets now have a one-goal lead in the first period. Perhaps they can build on this and carry something sizable to the dressing room. Let's it go. Score! And the game is even.
When you're thinking about taking a wrist shot, it's all about weight transfer. Transferring your weight from your back foot to your front foot when you're shooting that puck. That's exactly what happened there.
Enzo, I got a good look at this one. He's in the butterfly. It looks from my position like he's got the entire net covered. Obviously, there's a little bit open.
Acrobatic stop!
Out of position, never. What a stop.
Shot on goal. Score! He's got his second of the game.
Goaltender had no chance stopping that puck with the quick release.
Well, he can't get his pad down quick enough to make this stop. Really good shot, as you mentioned, Eddie. I think that's one he should probably stop.
The Canucks have broken the tie. Perhaps they can build on this lead here in the first period. Face-off win, and now what will they do with it? Shoots. Save. Good work with the stick. Has it picked up. Knocked right off the stick. Kelowna's in their own end, carrying it off. Into the attacking end. He throws it there. Puck is thrown to Reinhardt. He's in! Outstanding stop! A shot, and it's driven away. Good stick down on the ice, so nothing good happening there. Got it in his own end. Good defensive play. Loose puck, though. Wonderful save. It didn't look like he had a thing to shoot at.
Not a lot of room to score from in that area. Great save.
Didn't handle it very well. Free puck. Shoots. Wonderful save. What a skill level there. Gets in. What'll he do? Fires a shot. Deflected off the blocker. Gaining space. Maybe time. Finally lifted back out so they can get some fresh troops out. Good pass up that wing. Oh, what a play! Passing one off now to Fain. And the pickup. Pass right up the wing. Pass cut. And they've got it again. Up the wing, still with possession and with hope. He turned that one away with the blocker. The Rockets have it up the wing. And he steps in. Picks it up back there. Pitching this one to Laterra. Gains the zone. Breakaway! He scores! Three straight goals.
He had people chasing him down on a breakaway, but he found a way to score.
Well, the goaltender wants to be aggressive here, but this is just perfectly delivered.
The The Canucks go up by two. Some first period breathing room here. Just a little over 6 minutes to go here in the first. Just recently another goal, and so the lead is two. Pass attempt to Stewart. Okay, so he's got it on his stick. What'll he do next? Point blank save.
You don't get many better opportunities than that. Great save.
Score! Four goals in a row for the same team.
Stewart's body position was key to be able to snap this one home.
And so he looks like he's in pretty good positioning here, but he's not able to get his glove low enough to snap this one up.
The Canucks win that neutral zone faceoff. Hammered! That one's off the frame. Heads to the front. Great work with the pad.
14 minutes, 55 seconds.
The Canucks get the draw. Oh, what a stop.
You're going to be seeing that save a lot in the future, Doc.
Wristed one. The Rockets wheel one ahead up the wing. And possession has changed. Brilliant move on that pass.
The Canucks have a decided advantage in this game because of their ability to force turnovers.
He's in on an onside play. Big chance! Great save! The clock bleeds down to the last minute. Shoots! Score! The hat trick! It's not really loud in here, but they don't expect that.
You want to score goals, you've got to get to this area of the ice.
He just wasn't able to get over and cover the top of the net. The shot's perfect. It's right in the roof, and the goalie's dejected.
The Canucks prevail on the draw. Elevator. He's alone. He scores. Second of the game. What a performance.
To be cherry picking in behind the defense, and it worked. He found himself on a breakaway.
Stewart's able to clear open ice, and he lays a sweet saucer pass on the shooter's stick.
The Canucks got that faceoff win. Now what?
12, Yuri Lehterä.
That's a marvelous save.
You talk about cutting down the angle, perfectly executed by the goaltender.
Pass comes to him from the crease. And the first period ends.
The good old days of hockey are back. Vintage jerseys are now available at kiosks throughout the arena and at our main store. Pick yours up before their history again.
The Rockets are suffering on the goaltender. For him, there are great days, there are average days, and then there's today. More in a moment. One period played, a second period is about to begin. What do you think of what we've seen so far?
Kelowna's lucky to still be in this game after the first period. They had turnover after turnover. I'm sure the coaches addressed that problem in the intermission.
Takes it right back. What a reaction save.
A quick developing play right in front. Almost looks like he's too close to the goaltender.
Let's go, Arister. Paddled aside. Pitching it, Bohorva. Shot down the ice, and it's an icing.
Well, the shooter's pretty disappointed, guys. He delivered that puck quickly. It was accurate, yet the goaltender was just better than him on the wrist shot.
The Canucks with a clean win on the draw. Driven toward center in the shadow of the boards by Erickson. Right into the slot. A magnificent pad save. Enormous collision. Oh, and we've got a man hurt here and probably something more to happen after.
The first concern is the injured player, Doc, but somebody has to respond.
The scrap is over, and now the penalties for sure, maybe repairs.
That fight ended with that huge punch at the end.
What's turned into a pretty ugly game for them takes another step towards that direction.
Good clean win. Shoots one. Terrific glove save, but it's loose. Carries it to the corner. Couldn't get through. Puck loose, strong defensive play by Beagle. Still with it in the defensive zone. From the outside. That play went offside. Whoa, now in the code, that means there might be something going on. These two guys don't like one another, and they're proving it now.
I thought the fight was over when it started. My mistake. It ended with that huge right.
And they won the neutral zone faceoff. You win that, and you don't have to chase. They chase you. Score!
He had that look of no doubt he was going to score on that breakaway.
Whoa, it looks like his trapper's got a hole in it there, and so he gets beat low to the glove side.
Goalie to the bench, substitution made.
The Rockets are trying to change momentum here. Their starter had just a rotten night in goal. They'll get the backup in there.
The Canucks have gotten another goal on a huge night for them. We have seen this a lot. They're rolling. Solid win at center ice. Now what? Ryan Strome. Shot! Score!
Kane's anticipation allowed him to get that puck on the backhand and put it in the net.
That looks like it almost went right through him, Enzo. Just above the pad, he's in the butterfly. It's on the low glove side. It's a save a goal he should make.
The Canucks have gotten another goal on a night of many goals. What a satisfying night for them, and their coach won't have much to say. Kane, assisted by number 44. Has it in his own end. Chip to Strome. Waits from the corner. Laid on to Beagle. Didn't get through. Terrific pass through the middle. He's got it on his stick. Snapping a pass to Savard. The Canucks lug that along in the defensive zone. Propelled to Laterra. Hung right over him and couldn't get it past.
The goalie makes himself look big.
Good face-off win. Good chance here, but a terrific pad save. It's redirected. Oh, what a stop. Kelowna's lugging it up the wing. Into the end of attack. And he's tripped, and there'll be a penalty. And we get a penalty here. The referee strides over to hand it out. Goligoski's headed to the penalty box. A minor for tripping. There's always a start to your power play night, and this is number one.
9 minutes, 40 seconds.
The Rockets have control of the puck in their own end. Just a gentle hit, but he still got it. And he gains the zone. He's all alone! Score! What an impressive goal, shorthanded. We go down to the benches. It's Ray Ferraro.
Word from the home team's locker room is they're going to be short a player for the rest of the night. The injury occurred a while ago. He will not return.
A shot. They score! A shorthanded goal for multiple times in this game.
Palat's been known to go to the front of the net. Here he scores on the backhand.
That's a save a goaltender's got to make. It's a low glove side. Got to be able to catch that.
The Canucks have added to their overwhelming score, and they continue to have the puck most of the time. To Reinhardt.
Andre Palat, assisted by number 16.
Superb defensive play by Gardner.
Time of the goal.
Gets in, and he'll look over his options. Wonderful save. To Reinhardt. Oh, they got it out. They check the clock and prepare to defend some more. The Canucks with a big penalty kill. We're back at full strength. Enormous hit.
I wonder if that hit will
score. Kane.
Kane's decision was pretty easy. This low in a slot, just snap.
Big advantage in time of possession, and it shows in the score. They've got the draw. Onside.
Evander Kane, time of the goal.
Behind the net.
15 seconds.
To Palat. A shot. Oh, that one hit someone on the way. Pass cut. The Canucks through the neutral zone, controlling play now. Steps, score! What a phenomenal night for this guy.
You get this close to the goaltender, the puck on your stick, you gotta snap it quick.
I don't know, Edzo, how he could do much more than that. The shooter's got all kinds of room to put it in. The goaltender never gives up on the play, but it's in the back of the cage.
The Canucks have added to their overwhelming score, and they continue to have the puck most of the time. Kelowna's got that neutral zone faceoff.
Assisted by number 18, Andre Palat.
Picks it up in his own end. The Canucks are moving the puck in neutral ice.
45 seconds.
To the slot. Slid to Ladd. The Rockets want to generate something up the wing.
Good stick presence. The Canucks have been a turnover machine. That's why they have a huge lead in this game.
Gains the zone. Pass cut, strong play. Trying to go to Ladd. Attack zone possession here. A shot, score!
Quick wrist shot, surprised the goaltender in close.
Well, I get a good look at this one. The stick side shoulder is open. The shot is perfect, and as he's down in the butterfly, he can't get his hands up to cover it.
The Canucks have built a tremendous lead and also built some wonderful confidence. What will they say in the second intermission? Probably not much. And they've won the neutral zone faceoff.
Number 16, Andrew Ladd.
Players tired, about to get a rest. Score! He's got his second of the game. The Canucks have built a tremendous lead here in the second period. Not a lot of time left, but an entire third ahead. Perhaps they can enlarge it even more. Directing that one to Perron.
Chris Stewart, assisted by number 58, David Savard.
Good place to shoot from.
Yuri Lehterä. Time of the goal, 19 minutes.
Carried right through the middle of the neutral zone. That's two periods in the books. One more to go, but a rest comes first.
Hey, kids, don't forget, if you're a member of our rookie team, you'll have the opportunity to have a couple of our players sign autographs after the game.
40 minutes down, at least 20 minutes to go. What are your thoughts so far?
The Canucks have had their way the first 40 minutes of play pretty much in every category possible, most importantly with this real comfortable lead. Do they sit on it or look to add to it here in the third?
Great job with the neutralized interception. The breakaway, and he got that one. Puck out in front. A ripper from the point. The Rockets with possession up the wing. Good intercept. Gets in, looks over his options here. Breakaway chance, he scores! What a tremendous night for him.
Oh, he looked confident on that breakaway right before he scored.
Absolutely a great shot, Enzo, but the goaltender dropped down just a bit quick, left the top of the net exposed.
Horvat, just like his team, winning everything. One, he scores!
Erickson's decision was pretty easy. This low in a slot, just snap it home.
It looked to me like he had stopped this shot. He had a big chunk of it, but it worked its way into the net.
A little under 3 minutes play. The Canucks offense has exploded. This is a full-scale blowout. Now it's directed to Palat. Looks ahead to start something. Oh, and the pass wouldn't go. Gains the zone and looks over his options. The Canucks are moving the puck through the neutral zone. It all alone! Outstanding stop! A shot! Score! He's got his second!
Goaltender had no chance stopping that puck with the quick release.
Really good positioning. He's in the butterfly where he's got most of the net covered, but there's obviously a hole in the pucks behind him.
And they've taken that faceoff between the blue lines and won it. And snapped up by Fain. Puck loose. Good defensive play.
6 minutes, 2 seconds.
Nicely into the zone. He's alone. Terrific determination by Kane. Let's it go. Waffle boarded. And he freezes for the whistle. Hey, Ray, what's going on down there?
This is one of the game's great problems. When you score so many goals, your arms get tired raising them up and down.
It is just another in a long line of outstanding games for him, Ray. The Canucks win it. Oh, he got that! Clean win on the draw. To Sutter. Lets it go. Good pad save. At the front of the net. He scores! Second of the game. What a performance.
You want to to score goals, you've got to get to this area of the ice.
Strome's displayed some sweet hands. That's a soft dish right on the tape.
Kelowna's collected another victory on the faceoff. Possession seized by Ladd. On to Riley. That puck's loose, went off someone. Shoots. Score! He's got the hat trick. And listen, the only ones you can hear are his teammates.
When you're thinking about taking a wrist shot, it's all about weight transfer. Transferring your weight from your back foot to your front foot when you're shooting that puck. That's exactly what happened there.
A lot of times the goaltender feels like his positioning is perfect and he's got the net covered. Guess what? He doesn't.
Kelowna's got that one. Now what? It's an onside play. He heads right for the net. He scores!
Perron's body position was key to be able to snap this one home.
Whoa, it looks like his trapper's got a hole in it there, and so he gets beat low to the glove side.
And they've won the faceoff.
Scored by number 57, David Perron. Time of the goal.
Nicely into the zone. The Rockets luck that along up the wing. One into another.
There's a phrase in hockey, hit or be hit. That's exactly what happened.
Carried toward the neutral zone. The Rockets up the wing are moving the puck. Oh, that's a nice cut pass. Let's see what happens.
The Canucks have a decided advantage in this game because of their ability to force turnovers.
Moving it to Laterra. Breakaway! Oh, what a stop! The Rockets are starting back in the defensive zone. Terrific hit slowing them down. And that will help to at least clear the puck away. He is slashed, and there'll be a penalty for that. Gets across, looks over his options. And play is stopped for a penalty. The Canucks get a minor penalty for slashing.
Oh, that's a blatant slash, Doc. Anytime that you slide your bottom hand up your stick and swing your stick, you're going to the box.
The Rockets' power play gets another chance to operate. Hasn't been effective yet. Good job on the draw. Riley's got it on his stick, trying to get it out of there. Puck controlled by Beagle. A shot. Blocked that one. A shot. Score! A shorthanded goal yet again.
Beagle's decision was pretty easy. This low in the slot, just snap it off, and he did.
The goaltender wants to be aggressive here, but this is just perfectly delivered.
The Canucks control from the neutral zone. And he picks it up.
Assisted by number 18, Andre.
Looking to Kane.
By number 44.
Breakaway. He scores. And that's the hat trick. There won't be many on the ice, if any. But he's got three goals.
He looked to be cherry-picking in behind the defense, and it worked. He found himself on a breakaway.
Low stick side used to be an area that you shot all the time, but now that the goaltenders are in the butterfly, it's not as easy to beat, but this one goes through him pretty quickly.
A face-off win. Let's see what develops.
Scored shorthanded by number 9, Evander Kane, assisted by number 50.
Gets in. What'll he do? Oh, great cut.
17 minutes, 48 seconds.
Puck is thrown to Kane. The Canucks have killed it off. Let's it go. He scores. Kane. Horvat's won again, and so is his team. Everything's good there.
Evander Kane
puts one on. What an acrobatic stop. Wonderful recovery.
He lost his net, but was able to regain positioning and make an unbelievable save.
And let's hear again from Ray.
The Canucks have been up on their toes all night. They've been the more aggressive team, and as a result, they've controlled play.
You're right, Ray. This is a physical game, especially played by the team that's up on the scoreboard. Big face-off win. Great glove save, but it's loose. We are in the last minute of regulation time. He scores! He completes the hat trick.
Eriksson's anticipation allowed him to get that puck on the backhand and put it in the net.
Palat's able to clear open ice, and he lays a sweet saucer pass on the shooter's stick.
Canucks with a win at center.
His third of the game, scored by number 21.
He's going to the net. Score! The hat trick. It's not really loud in here, but they don't expect that.
Palat's quick wrist shot surprised the goaltender in close.
The goalie thinks he's got the bottom half of the net covered. Obviously, he doesn't, as this goes by him on the low stick side.
The Rockets with a center ice face-off win. The Canucks lug the puck in their own end. Right into the slot. Score! What a phenomenal night for this guy.
Ladd's been known to go to the front of the net. Here he scores on the backhand.
I think when he takes a look at this on video, he's going to see he was in really good position, and he just wasn't able to stop a perfect shot.
And the faceoff's won. Passing one off now to Sutter. Puck loose, couldn't get through. Kelowna's moving the puck up the wing. Great job on a cut pass.
The Canucks have a healthy lead in this game because of their turnover.
Curls on back and waits for more. And he's all alone. Score! Another goal!
Quick read of the play, allowed him to get that breakaway and score.
And so just because you're in the butterfly doesn't mean you can give in to the shooter. You still have to move. He looked like he thought he was in perfect shape to make the stop and didn't have to move. Bad guess.
They win the draw and will now set up an attack. And it's driven away.
Time of the goal, 19 minutes, 53 seconds.
The clock is at zeros. The game is over. The Canucks have won big in this one.
Much easier to play with the puck as they did all night long.
That's it for another great night at a hockey rink. For Eddie and Ray, Doc saying good evening, everyone.